Nowadays, that's more important than ever. With hundreds of films, TV series, and online videos competing for our attention, filmmakers and distribution companies need to find creative ways to make their content stand out. In the earliest days of film, movies were the marketing. People bought tickets just to see pictures move on a screen. As it became clear that film was going to endure as a source of mass entertainment and communication, a permanent infrastructure emerged. Things like movie studios and theater chains. Those studios started making more and more movies to keep up with demand, and suddenly, moviegoers had options. Audiences also became more sophisticated viewers. They wanted stories, and they wanted stars. Film studios and distributors were faced with greater competition and needed to find ways to persuade people to see their film instead of somebody else's. That's where marketing comes in. And in fact, many of the elements of cinema's earliest marketing campaigns are still with us today. In the 1910s, the studios that made and distributed films noticed that more people bought tickets for movies starring actors like Florence Lawrence, Mary Pickford, and Lillian Gish. So they began to market their films based on celebrities, which helped create the star system. Celebrities continue to be a powerful weapon in a film's marketing arsenal to this day. They can be deployed to talk shows, magazine spreads, or press junkets, where hundreds of journalists are wined, dined, and given a few precious moments to interview a personality. Today's celebrities also leverage their own social media to increase hype around their movies. But as flashy as the star system is, in many ways, the cornerstone of film marketing is the poster, or one sheet. Whether they're organized around an iconic image from the film, or covered with the movie's most famous actors, these graphic designs can be used in print ads, transformed into billboards, or displayed outside theaters. Companies like Coca-Cola or Frito-Lay would pay to have their products featured in movies aimed at an audience they hoped to reach, and it often worked. For instance, after Hershey's agreed to spend $1 million marketing Steven Spielberg's E.T. in exchange for a prominent use of Reese's Pieces in the film, sales of the candy jumped by a whopping 65% in just 2 weeks. And the internet has revolutionized movie marketing in many ways. Not only is it cheaper to deliver trailers over the web, but marketing departments can now target their material to very specific audiences. And savvy use of social media can amplify the marketing team's message. So rather than paying to advertise on every major television network, the marketing team of a new animated film can aim ads directly at, say, people whose browser histories indicate that they have young kids.
Girlfriend Katie, she thinks there's something in the house, I don't know.
You believe me, right?
I think we're gonna have a very interesting time capturing whatever paranormal phenomena is occurring or is not occurring.
Windows and locks, doors and locks, alarm is on.
Hearing a weird sound.
Something's here. I feel it breathing on me.
Footsteps in, but there's no footsteps out.
Oh, God. Oh, my God.
If you do try to play games with it, that's inviting it in.
Jeez, this looks like something bit you.
It's not the house, it's me.
You cannot run from this, it will follow you.
You're in control.
You're not in control.
What's happening to me?
This thing left a message.
If it's not a ghost, what is it?
Like every good horror movie does, quietly. But paranormal activity quickly caused blood-curdling noise at the box office, largely because of Viacom's savvy planning.
It's rolling out very gradually with a very unique marketing strategy where They're almost forcing the market to demand the release in each market.
In fact, a button on the movie's website actually urged fans to demand the film be screened in their town. Now, whether or not this was just a marketing tactic or real fan participation, it certainly seemed to work.
This has got to be one of the most profitable movies ever created.
Remember, it only cost $15,000 to make, and in just 2 weeks grossed over $62 million in nationwide release.
Industry experts say the film could end up raking in $200 million worldwide, and that does not include lucrative DVD sales or television contracts.
Not too shabby for a movie that used Twitter, Facebook, and other social networking sites exclusively to get the word out before buying one television ad. Paranormal Activity, a marketing phenomenon that may haunt Paramount's competition for some time to come.
Please, please.